GitCon with Derek from Rev and Two Notes.
Yep.
Right? I was talking to him earlier, and one of the problems I have in the Tone Lounge is when I have an amp, and I have like a 100-watt, let's say Marshall, or whatever the amp may be, when I do a demo, I always listen to the amp through a cabinet.
Yep.
And sometimes that's harsh on the ears. So sometimes I'll use a hot plate, but then, you know, how do you get that, you know, into, then you have to mic things up. It's just like this whole rigmarole. So I was talking to you about different ways I can solve that problem, which if you're recording in a home studio or whatever the case may be, you may benefit from what you're about to learn right now, because he architected a solution for me with some of the products that he has here. And why don't you talk a little bit about what's up there right now?
So what we're building for TK for the Tone Lounge is a combination of using two of our products. One, the Torpedo Capper will act as a load box so that he can drive his 100-watt head into it as hard as he wants to be able to get kind of the sweet spot for pushing his tubes into the power section on his amp. He's going to run the through output from the Torpedo Capper attenuated into his cabinet down 20 decibels so that he can still use his cabinet for reference in the Tone Lounge without killing his eardrums and that. And then he'll send a signal from this into a Torpedo Cab, which is essentially a virtual cabinet or an IR loader. And he'll be able to choose his virtual cab and mic that he wants to use and send that to his DAW, and that's how he's going to generate his guitar tones rather than having to mic up a cab every time he sits down to do some recording. So what we're going to show you today is the attenuation feature on the Torpedo Capper and show you just how effective that 20 dB cut that we have on it is. Mm-hmm. So why don't you play some riffs? Yep. And you know, yeah, this is that full wattage, even yeah, without the attenuation.
Sounds good too.
Well, thanks, man. And here it is, down 20 dB. So you can actually talk over top of the cabinet quite easily without yelling.
That's right. And that's actually will help me do my demos, because you get the, you know, there's two ways you could hear an amp, with the volume very low, but you don't really get the body of the amp.
Yeah.
Or you could turn the amp all the way up and get the body.
Yeah, like this. Which would kill your eardrums wasn't attenuated down. So yeah, because this is 120 watts and that was almost dimed into the captor. The captor is capable of taking 100 watts and even if you do push more than 100 watts into it, it will go into a security mode if it starts to overheat and overload. So you're not going to damage your head if that happens. Your power section will still be okay. It'll just kind of attenuate your volume down even more while it cools down. And mm-hmm. Yeah.
And there's a couple of other features on there, because it'll also do a DI if you didn't want the cab module. Do you want to talk about that?
Yeah, so you can send it direct out. I'm not sure how easily you can see this, but you can send direct out either using a balanced TRS connection, or you can use the DI out and use the quarter or the XLR connection direct to your interface.
So it wouldn't be an IR, but you could still get some level of...
Yeah, you can send either just straight line level signal that is not colored in any way, shape, or form, or you can switch to the built-in analog guitar sim or the bass cabinet sim, either one.
And that output level is so you could adjust what's going into your DAW or whatever you're sending it into.
You got it, just so you don't clip the input on your DAW. Yeah, it's really great. And like the analog... speaker sim that's built in, it does sound good. I still do prefer to use either wall of sound and a virtual cabinet over top of it, but you know, this will definitely
Gotcha.
Definitely do compared to, you know, most other solutions that you have on the market right now.
And you could take that XLR, go into your DAW, and still use Wall of Sound in your software.
Absolutely.
Gotcha. There it is. Do you want to tell me a little bit about the amp, since it's sounding so tasty?
Sure. Okay, so the Generator 120 is our flagship amp. Mm-hmm. It's our four-channel, 120-watt monster. The first channel is your clean channel.
Sounds great.
Yeah, the clean on it, I really applaud Dan Trudeau, our president and designer. A lot of the times with high-gain amps, you find that they do like high-gain metal tones or rock tones really well, but the clean channels are really stiff and sterile, and a lot of guys opt to use a Fender or something different for their clean channels, where the cleans on the Generator series and on the Dynamis, to me, are actually some of the best channels on the amps. Mm-hmm. They're really transparent, really great to pedal up. Yeah, so it's really nice, because in the past, playing other metal amps, I've almost always opted to use a Fender amp for mm-hmm. cleans over them. So your second channel is your crunch channel. It's more Brit-based.
Yep.
Yeah, exactly. Cool feature though, if you dime the gain, it gets almost like a little bit of a fuzz box. Just kind of right on the verge of a fuzz box, which is really nice, especially for leads.
That's great.
Channel 3 was what you heard before. Now, all of the rev stuff has a lot of switches.
Mm-hmm.
The nice thing about the way the switching works, though, is I find that everything is always stepping up, and it makes sense what it's doing, where some other amps I've played, some of the switching is really hard to figure out on what it does. So on the front, we've got a bright, which is a treble push. You've got a contour, which is a low mid push. You've got a fat, which is a low push. And then the aggression, which is kind of our trademark thing, is essentially gain boosts. So you start out here. Go ahead and play.
Action.
Okay. So there's your first gain level. There's your second one. And your third. And it just kind of gets thicker and thicker. It still remains tight. As it gets thicker.
So crank up the master on there. By the way, when I stop playing and you have that peg,
it's quiet.
It's really quiet.
Yeah, the noise.
Some high gain amps and they just squeal.
The noise floor is very, very low on our amps.
Mm-hmm.
And that's the third channel. The fourth channel is voiced kind of similarly, but it's got a little more bottom end to it, a little bit thicker sounding. Okay. Thanks, man. And all of your momentary toggle functions on here are also MIDI controllable, mm-hmm. or our footboard, which is not sitting here right now.
Mm-hmm.
It's out in the showroom. You can program the different toggle functions into the foot switch as presets. So it's got a 6-button foot switch, so you can essentially have 6 presets for playing live. So the way I use it is like channel 1 will be set on button 1 on the foot switch, channel 2 will be button 2. Button 3 will be the third channel with the first aggression level. And channel 4, or button 4, not channel 4, sorry. Button 4 will be the third aggression level, just using it as a boost. And then same with button 5, I'll go to the fourth channel, aggression off. And then button 6 will be the third level of aggression. So there's a lot of tonal options. And the amps really work well. Like, we have guys in the country market and guys in the metal market using them. Because they clean up really well, and if you pull the gain back, like, I actually mainly play Telecasters and play more, like, blues-based hard rock. And, I mainly just roll the gains almost off and then use the aggression as a boost for, for doing leads.
Could you try that?
Yeah, we'd need a single coil guitar, though. We can do it a little bit with
that. Yeah, try. Let's see what we can do.
So that's it. So, I mean, we have other options. This is a generator series. So we have the generator 100, which is essentially a two-channel version of this. And the generator 740, which is different power section, but again, like a two-channel version of it.
How'd you come up with the name Rev?
I didn't. So Dan Trudeau, who's our president, had built the first prototype 120, and he had built one for another studio in Winnipeg when him and I met. And he had already named and branded the company beforehand. So.
Gotcha.
Yeah. Works great, though. Like, it's really easy for marketing to say Rev It Up.
Yeah,
revolutionary,
yeah.
So.
Sure.
Yeah.
That's awesome. Well, thank you for
going through that,
and stay tuned. Maybe we get to see some Rev stuff coming up real soon.
Yeah, sounds great.
And Two Note stuff.
Yeah. Awesome.
From GitzCon in Germany. Later.